Humbly, I am Pythor P. Chumsworth, and since you freed me, I'm eternally in your service.
From a prisoner to the Serpentine King, and back to a prisoner. Pythor P. Chumsworth was known as the last remaining member of the fearsome Anachondri tribe. At first glance, Pythor is polite and friendly, but his true personality is very arrogant and scheming, happy to betray anyone to further his own goals. Although Pythor was part of a ferocious tribe, he was shown to be cowardly when the odds were not in his favor. However, the times when Pythor kept his cool, he was intelligent enough to be considered a true threat to Ninjago. It is also important to mention that Pythor was sadistic. He cannibalized his own people and threatened to destroy Ninjago for revenge. His insanity only increased tenfold after he was defeated by the ninja over and over again. With that out of the way, I present to you the complete history of Pythor. More than 40 years ago, Pythor was a low-ranking member of the Anachondri tribe when tensions between humans and Serpentine were high. When they heard from Chen that the humans were about to attack, Pythor and the other Anachondri felt compelled to strike first, thus beginning the First Serpentine War. Pythor participated in many battles against the Elemental Alliance, securing many victories along the way. However, the Elemental Alliance then created the Sacred Flutes, subduing and controlling the Serpentine. While the Anachondri generals were banished to the Cursed Realm, Pythor and the other Anachondri were sealed away in a tomb in the Sea of Sand. Over the next four decades, the Anachondri were starved and resorted to cannibalism to survive. With Pythor being the sole survivor, he waited alone for the chance to escape his imprisonment. After being released by the young Lloyd Garmadon, a camouflaged Pythor snuck up on the boy and jump-scared him. The last Anachondri introduced himself as Pythor P. Chumsworth and explained that the other Anachondri starved to death after being locked away in the tomb for so long. Pythor then pledged himself as Lloyd's servant in exchange for freeing him from his imprisonment, helping the boy commit several acts of mischief across Ninjago. After a day of this, the duo returned to the tomb and ate their candy. Pythor then learned that Lloyd was kicked out of his old boarding school, Darkly's School for Bad Boys, and told his master that they should attack the school in the morning as revenge. When Lloyd fell asleep, Pythor attempted to steal the map that led to the other Serpentine tombs, but was thwarted when the boy rolled over, congratulating Pythor for being such a good minion. The next day, Pythor and Lloyd attacked Darkly's, tying up its occupants and setting booby traps for the eventual arrival of the ninja. Unfortunately for the duo, the ninja evaded the traps and cornered them on the roof. Seeing the opportunity, Pythor stole the map from Lloyd, mocking the child for believing that he could control the Serpentine. With that, Pythor turned invisible and left Lloyd to be apprehended by the ninja. With the map of dens in his possession, Pythor began tracking down the Serpentine tombs, releasing the Constricti and the Venomari to ambush the ninja. Pythor waited in the toxic bogs to jumpscare Kai and Jay when they were surrounded by Serpentine. Cole and Zane arrived and attempted to neutralize the snakes with the sacred flute, but it was snatched away by Pythor. The last Anachondri watched with satisfaction as the ninja were cornered onto a log in a pool of acid, believing it was the last he would see of the four. Unfortunately for Pythor, Samurai X arrived and chased the snakes away, with Pythor being shot with a dart before he escaped. Although his foes eluded him, Pythor proceeded with his plans, gathering the Serpentine tribes in Ninjago City's subway tunnels in a quest to unite them. The snakes were originally receptive, but Pythor began losing them when the ninja infiltrated their meeting, throwing insults among the crowd. Hypnobride General Scales spotted the ninja running around and apprehended them, except for Zane. The pink ninja later kicked the generals off their perch and freed his friends. By the time Pythor recovered, Zane froze their escape tunnel, causing the Anachondri to slip and fall. With his plans ruined, Pythor took his anger out on Scales, who attempted to dissuade the Anachondri from uniting the tribes.
Get your hands off me!
Again trying to unite the tribes, Pythor searched for the lost city of Ouroboros in the Sea of Sand. Scales continued to tell Pythor that his dream was unattainable until the Anachondri found a switch that caused the city to rise from the ground. Pythor then ordered Scales to gather the Serpentine to meet at Ouroboros, planning to unite the tribes by defeating the other serpentine generals. Prior to the fight, Pythor promised to make Scales his second-in-command if he played his part. When Scales agreed, Pythor stuffed cotton balls in his ears and declared to the other serpentine that he would claim leadership of the tribes by defeating their generals in a slither pit battle. During the fight, Pythor was pinned down by Phanctum, Scalador, and Acidicus until Scales handed the Anacondri general the sacred flute. Pythor was then able to neutralize the generals using the flute, knocking them down and stealing their staffs. Having defeated the generals, Pythor then declared himself as the Serpentine King. Suddenly, a pair of maracas fell into the arena, revealing a disguised Lloyd among the Serpentine. Taking advantage of his new prisoner, Pythor used Lloyd to lure the ninja to Ouroboros. Trapping the ninja and stealing their golden weapons, Pythor then forced them to battle Samurai X. Unfortunately, the samurai helped the ninja escape and went to free Lloyd. Pythor ordered his serpentine minions to attack, but the mysterious samurai escaped with the golden weapons. However, Pythor managed to keep Lloyd. With the serpentine united, Pythor initiated the next step in his plan, finding the four fang blades to reawaken the Great Devourer. However, the only clue to their location was in this cryptic riddle. As the Anacondri furiously pondered the answer, Scales warned him that the other serpentine would grow restless and begin asking questions. Acidicus and Scalador then took their staffs back in the face of Pythor's incompetence, resulting in a scuffle between the generals. However, Pythor found the answer when he noticed the anti-venoms of the staffs combining. Realizing that the riddle meant the serpentine staffs and not the tribes, Pythor put the five staffs together over a slab. Placing a piece of paper beneath the staffs, Pythor and the generals watched as the anti-venoms created the map of fangs. Amid the cheers of his fellow serpentine, Pythor then declared that they would hunt for the fang blades, reawaken the Great Devourer, and take back Ninjago for themselves. Pythor discovered the location of the first fang blade at Mega Monster Amusement Park. The serpentine arrived at the park via underground tunnels dug by the Constricti. Scales suggested that they should come back at night so as to not attract any unwanted attention, but Pythor thought that they would easily fit in. A family asked to take a picture with the Anacondri, and the snake humbly agreed. However, the picture reached the ninja, prompting them to go there. Pythor later found the first fang blade at the ghost train attraction when they were stopped by the ninja. However, Zane accidentally froze his friends, allowing the serpentine to escape. The villains found Samurai X waiting outside and had the fang blade stolen from them. However, the snakes managed to pull the mech to the ground. Pythor ordered his minions to reveal the identity of the samurai, who turned out to be Nia. The Snake King then ordered the others to tie the girl to a roller coaster where she would be burned alive. Suddenly, Jay showed up and attempted to stop them, but he was slowly turning into a snake due to the fangpire venom, causing Pythor to mock him. Jay wanted to attack, but saw Nia trapped on the roller coaster and went after her instead, allowing the serpentine to escape. After acquiring the first fang blade, Pythor located the second one in a pyramid in the Sea of Sand. Pythor sent Lloyd to fetch the fang blade to protect himself and the other serpentine from the traps. The boy later reported that the fang blade was missing. Some serpentine later told Pythor about Ninjago talent, with the blade cup being the main prize. Pythor and Scales then spied on the ninja preparing for the competition from the sewers. The serpentine later decided to enter the talent show, calling themselves the Troublemakers. Pythor infiltrated the backstage and ate one of the judges, gluing a fake beard to his chin and pretended to be the third judge. The real judge still spoke within his belly, but Pythor silenced him. He then watched the other performances and enjoyed the Troublemakers' music when it was their turn. The Anacondri gave them a perfect rating and forced the other judges to do the same. When the ninja didn't show up for their performance, Pythor tried persuading the judges to end the competition, but the heroes appeared at the last minute, irritating Pythor. The Snake King ordered his minions to interfere with the ninja's performance, but they were unsuccessful. By the end, Pythor rated them a 0, but the real judge stuck his hand out of Pythor's mouth and gave the ninja a 10. The Anacondri demanded a recount, but was ignored. Later, the ninja retreated backstage where Cole reunited with his father. However, Pythor ordered two Constricti to crush Cole and Lou. With the ninja distracted, Pythor fled with the second fang blade. According to the map, the third fang blade was located at the Fire Temple. The Serpentine went to the volcano with an imprisoned Lloyd. Pythor ordered his minions to dig in search of the fang blade, disturbing the stability of the volcano. Finding the third fang blade, Pythor noticed the ninja entering the volcano and ordered an attack. After a brief battle, Pythor fled the scene, but not before ordering some constricti to destabilize the volcano with the heroes still inside. Before managing to escape, Kai threw his sword at the fang blade, getting it stuck in the wall. An enraged Pythor desperately tried to get it out, but was forced to leave it behind. On the way down the volcano after its eruption, Pythor noticed a fang blade drifting down the river of lava and grabbed it with his staff. Shortly after finding the third fang blade, Pythor went after the fourth one in an unknown place. However, before leaving, Pythor set a trap for the ninja in the Serpentine's new underground fortress, knowing the meddling heroes would go after the captured fang blades. The Snake King later returned satisfied that the ninja fell into their trap. While the ninja were trapped in the cage hanging from the ceiling, Pythor immediately wanted to go to Ouroboros, but Scales persuaded his master to stay and celebrate their victory. Pythor reluctantly agreed and chose to celebrate with the Slither Pit, but still ordered the Serpentine to stay on guard. However, Pythor still kept his eyes on the ninja and caught Kai trying to escape. Pythor imprisoned him again and handcuffed all the ninja. Later, Lloyd broke into the fort and Pythor laughed at the young green ninja. However, Garmadon suddenly appeared with the help of the Skulkin army. Pythor then ordered an attack and pulled a lever that lowered the cage holding the ninja into a pool of acid. Pythor himself engaged in a brief battle, but was taken down by Cole and had the fang blades taken from him. Aware of his defeat, Pythor became invisible and snuck onto the Destiny's Bounty, laughing at his devious plan. After infiltrating the ship, Pythor entered the training room where Lloyd was practicing. The invisible Anacondri revealed himself and tied the boy to a pole. Then he used a hammer to destroy the bounty's generator. Due to this, Sensei Wu fell off the ship before he was caught by the ninja. At this time, Lloyd managed to free himself and informed everyone through the speaker that Pythor was on board. The green ninja then confronted the Anacondri, the latter mocking the boy's sloppiness. However, Nia in her samurai mech arrived, leaving Pythor shivering in his timbers. Pythor then jumped off the bounty with the fang blades and was caught by a rattlecopter below. The Snake King complained that the copter was not going fast enough, but Scales took him to a tour bus that the Serpentine had commandeered earlier for transport to Ouroboros. During the ride, Pythor was informed of the ninja pursuing the bus and ordered the Fangpire to transform it into the Serpentine Express. He later kicked the driver out for driving too slow, taking control of the bus and ignoring the warnings of an engine explosion. When Sensei Wu disconnected the wagons from the control car, Pythor left the steering wheel to confront the old man, trying unsuccessfully to eat him. Finally, when the engine exploded and the car crashed, Pythor escaped from the wreckage and slithered his way to Ouroboros. As the insane Anacondri placed the fang blades in the statue of the Great Devourer's mouth, Wu told him of his mistake, realizing with horror that the giant snake was below them the whole time and he had no control over it. Pythor attempted to flee, but Wu stopped him. After a fierce struggle, Pythor and Wu watched as the Great Devourer rose from the ground. Unable to escape due to Sensei Wu, the two were consumed by the Great Devourer. Unbeknownst to the ninja, Pythor survived his time in the Great Devourer's stomach, but his skin was bleached white. Following the Devourer's death, Pythor laid low and used his invisibility to spy on the ninja. He even went with them to the Dark Island and learned of the Overlord. He later returned to Ninjago with the ninja and began learning some computer skills. After New Ninjago City's power was knocked out, Pythor, under the identity of the Stranger, stole the digital Overlord hard drive and used Electro Cobri to power his computer in the sewers. He also converted Sensei Wu into the evil Techno Wu, now a servant of the Overlord. Later, when Techno Wu was defeated by the ninja in Ed and Edna's scrap and junk, a disguised Pythor freed him using a snake bow. While fleeing, Pythor accidentally left behind a white scale for the ninja to investigate. Returning to the sewers, the Overlord was dissatisfied that the mission yielded no results. Pythor, however, explained that the attack was merely a ploy to scare the ninja into warning Lloyd via the Falcon, which Pythor hacked to gain the Golden Ninja's location. While Pythor was busy working in his lab, the Overlord questioned why they weren't going after the Golden Ninja yet, despite knowing his whereabouts. Pythor informed the Dark Lord that their Electro Cobra supply had been depleted, and he planned to sneak into Ninjago City Aquarium to acquire more. While Wu's Academy students were taking a field trip at the aquarium, an invisible Pythor snuck in with them and used a whistle to shatter the tank that contained the Electro Cobra. The specimens then passed through a tube and into a tank on Pythor's boat in the sewers. After containing more Electro Cobra, Pythor could finally execute the next step of his plan, to capture Lloyd. Pythor deployed a squadron of ninjoids and Techno Wu to hunt down the Golden Ninja. While Lloyd was escaping, he was cornered by the mech dragon with his father, Sensei Garmadon, being held hostage. The Golden Ninja attempted to use his power to combat this new threat, but was coiled up by a snake strangler. Just then, the stranger walked up to a captured Lloyd and removed his hood, revealing himself to be Pythor. After explaining that the Great Devourer had bleached his scales white, Pythor boarded the mech dragon and watched as Garmadon was released into the sea below. With the villains finally acquiring the Golden Ninja, they flew back towards Ninjago City. Pythor and the ninjoid army stormed Borg Tower to prevent the ninja from erasing the digital overlord in the Digiverse. On the way to the top floor, the villains encountered Nia waiting for them. Pythor remembered her as Samurai X and fled the scene when she summoned her mech to fight the ninjoids. Arriving at the top floor, Pythor fought Pixel with a bone for a weapon, but he was quickly taken down. When Pixel accidentally knocked Techno Wu near the Master Switch, Pythor ordered him to press it so the ninja would be left behind in the Digiverse forever, like how he was left behind in the bowels of the Great Devourer. However, Wu was stopped by Garmadon, who was disguised as a ninjoid. Lloyd's father then attacked Pythor, but the Anaconjurai escaped via hovercopter. Following the attack on Borg Tower, Pythor led his ninjoids to the crashed mech dragon at the bottom of the sea. There, they retrieved the partially reformed overlord and brought the mech dragon to the surface. However, due to the golden power not transferring completely, the overlord was left as a blob of darkness. Pythor then consumed the Dark Lord to conceal him from the ninjoids. After the retrieval, Pythor and the ninjoids moved into the city of Ouroboros. At the base in Ouroboros, General Cryptor questioned Pythor's plan, stating how the ninjoids haven't seen the Overlord yet and were suspicious of Pythor's intentions. Cryptor then vowed that the Anaconjurai would pay dearly if he found out that Pythor was lying about the Overlord. Pythor then lashed out at the general, saying that the Overlord would appear when he wanted to and reminded Cryptor that he could always be reprogrammed. The Anaconjurai then left for another room where he vomited out the essence of the Overlord, declaring that Project Arcturus would be ready soon. Later, Pythor was in a truck transporting a shipment of fuel to Ouroboros. Kai was in pursuit of the villains, but Pythor noticed him when the Red Ninja accidentally shot missiles out of the prototype X-1. Pythor ordered Cryptor to speed up, later believing they lost Kai. However, Pythor ordered the general to stop when he heard Kai's voice. His suspicions were confirmed when he saw the ninja latched onto the bottom of the truck. Once at Ouroboros, Pythor tied Kai to the rocket's engines before the rest of the ninja came to rescue him. The Anaconjurai then watched as the rocket ship Arcturus flew into space. While in space, Cryptor found out that the ninja had snuck aboard and informed Pythor via radio. Pythor realized that someone from Ninjago had to have helped them and told Cryptor that he would take care of it. Later, Pythor and the ninjoid stormed Borg Tower once again, but this time with a capsule containing the Overlord. Making it to the top floor, the Overlord emerged from the capsule as a partially formed Golden Master. Suddenly, the villains heard a noise outside. Pythor realized that it was the ninja's allies and ordered the ninjoids to attack. However, the heroes escaped in a hovercopter. Having obtained the remnants of the golden weapons, Cryptor and the ninjoids returned from space. The Overlord ordered them to melt the golden weapons down into the golden armor, which Pythor acknowledged was currently underway. With the mech completed, the Overlord, now known as the Golden Master, began wreaking havoc in Ninjago City. Unfortunately for the villains, the ninja returned from space, much to Pythor's disbelief. As the Golden Master transformed Ninjago City into an impenetrable fortress, Pythor stood by his side, exclaiming that the civilians were losing hope and would soon bow down to their new Dark Lord. The Golden Master then created a giant web of golden power around Borg Tower. However, the villains realized that the ninja equipped the ancient stone warrior armor, protecting them against the golden power. Pythor told the Dark Lord to attack the people instead, but to his surprise, the serpentine came out of the sewers and helped the civilians escape. In a final attempt to take down the Golden Master, Wu and Garmadon tried hitting a shrinking pill into the Overlord's mouth, but Pythor took the hit in the last second. Astonished and infuriated, Pythor slithered away as the falcon pursued him. Once the Golden Master was destroyed, Pythor was arrested and taken to Cryptarium Prison. There, the guards gave him a dollhouse as a cell to match his small size. A tiny and mentally unstable Pythor was talking to his ball named Rodrigo when the ninja entered his cell. He refused to answer their questions for all the pain they put him through. However, the former Serpentine King changed his mind when he saw Garmadon as an Anachondri. Pythor then negotiated with the ninja that he would help them if they found a way to revert him back to his normal size. Just then, the Anachondri cultists broke into the prison searching for Pythor. Zane realized that they needed the essence from a true Anachondri to complete the transformation spell, so Lloyd, Garmadon, and Wu left to escape and keep Pythor out of the cultists' reach. As they made their escape, Garmadon and Wu mentioned how the Anachondri attacked first during the Serpentine War, but Pythor revealed the truth. The Anachondri wanted peace just as much as the humans, but Chen told them that the humans would lapse and ambush them. Lloyd then realized that Chen was playing both sides just so he would come out on top. When the four arrived at the courtyard, the Anachondri cultists ambushed them and a battle broke out. Lloyd later lost Pythor when he performed spinjitzu, allowing the cultists to seize the last living Anachondri. A captured Pythor was then forced to run on a wheel while being chased by a swamp rat so the fake Anachondri could gather his sweat, which contained the essence they needed to complete the ritual. Chen mocked the miniature Pythor and left him to his fate. After several hours of running on the wheel, Pythor wondered where the ninja were when he needed them. He quickly realized that he had to become a ninja himself and used the last of his energy to escape from the wheel. Pythor then found the Book of Spells and began looking for a spell to turn him back to his original size. During his search, Cyrus Borg's voice came over the radio, reporting the Anachondri attacks in Ninjago City. Pythor told himself that they were not real Anachondri, which gave him an idea to bring back the Anachondri generals from the Cursed Realm. When he learned the ninja were at the Corridor of Elders, Pythor took the Book of Spells and managed to tame the rat that was chasing him earlier on the wheel. Naming the rat Rodrigo, Pythor and Rodrigo left Chen's camp and galloped towards the ninja. As the climactic battle ensued in the Corridor of Elders, Pythor found Lloyd and persuaded the green ninja to take him to the Destiny's Bounty. Aboard the flying ship, Wu told Pythor that there was no way to stop the battle, but Pythor acknowledged that the fake Anachondri could be defeated by the original Anachondri. Garmadon lashed out at Pythor, telling him that the battle was not about making him big again until Pythor unveiled a spell to bring back the spirits of the Anachondri generals, who he knew would not stand for this. Garmadon then sacrificed himself to bring back the generals, who imprisoned Chen and the cultist in the Cursed Realm. When the battle was over, the Anachondri generals commended Pythor for his actions, saying that he finally made them proud. As a reward, the generals returned Pythor to his original size, much to his elation.
That's more like it!
Later, Pythor disappeared from the other heroes of the battle. Pythor attempted to adapt to life in Ninjago City as a civilian rather than a villain. He made efforts to try and fit in with the people of Ninjago and resisted his thoughts to scheme against them. Despite this, Pythor still aspired to conquer Ninjago. Pythor set off to the Ninjago Museum of History to check out the Hall of Villainy. Upon entering the exhibit, Pythor found that the other villain statues were missing except his own, much to his disappointment. After taking the fake Anachondri staff from his own statue, Pythor found the revived villains elsewhere in the exhibit. Being brought back to life by Sensei Yang, the villains were tasked with hunting the ninja to take their place among the living. The former Serpentine King quickly succumbed to the evil plan, longing to take revenge against the ninja. Greeting Cryptor and Chen as old friends, the group began choosing their opponents. Pythor chose Lloyd, marveling how he had taken out his father and would now go after the son. After, the Anachondri suggested that they bring some backup and went to the Hall of Sidekicks. Unfortunately, there were no serpentine statues for Yang to revive. Locating the Green Ninja at the Corridor of Elders, Pythor interrupted Lloyd and Misako's commemoration for Garmadon, asking if he still remembered what he told him during their last meeting. Lloyd suddenly remembered what the Anakontrai said on that fateful day.
If anyone is going to take over this world, I'd rather it be me.
Subsequently, Pythor attacked the family. As he and Lloyd fought, Pythor caused the head of a giant samurai statue to fall onto the Green Ninja. While struggling to hold it up, Pythor went after Misako until Lloyd found strength in remembering his father, using spinjitzu to escape from under the monument's remains. He and Misako pursued Pythor onto the top of Garmadon's monument, cornering him to the edge. Refusing to yield, the former Serpentine King decided to make a spectacular exit and leaped off of the monument. Although he survived the fall, Pythor was heavily injured and muttered to himself that he should have brought backup. He then slithered away, using his staff as a cane. The day after Day of the Departed, an invisible Pythor spied on the ninja and witnessed them going to the Borg store to talk about the new Borg Watch. Believing that the Borg Watch could help him gain attention in Ninjago, Pythor continued watching the ninja with curiosity. When the heroes left the store with the thermodynamic temperature gauge, a cloaked figure stood in their way, revealing himself to be Pythor. Lloyd mockingly asked if he wanted to fight again, to which Pythor laughed at. The Anakontrai explained how he realized that he would not gain recognition by defeating the ninja, and instead chose another way to command his attention. Pythor then hit Jay with his staff, knocking the device out of his hand. With it now in his possession, Pythor fled into a crowd of people to lose the ninja. Choosing instead to reveal the device to his fellow Serpentine first, Pythor opened a manhole cover and climbed into the sewers. After finding the Serpentine village, Pythor encountered his old chum, Scales. The Serpentine King was hesitant to let him in, but he eventually conceded. Inside the village, Pythor tried to convince the other Serpentine that he was still worthy of being one of them by revealing the Borg Watch prototype. Scales Jr. began to believe, but Pythor was then chased out of the village by the ninja. The Anakontrai then escaped from the sewer and attempted to show the device to the fans standing outside of the Borg store. When the crowd began to trust him, the ninja arrived and pretended to also have Borg Watch components to make Pythor sound like a cheater. Their plan worked out, but Pythor managed to escape. Following his failure, Pythor decided to go to the Ninjago News Center to reveal the Borg Watch component. When the ninja arrived, Pythor was already on stage with Gil Gossip to be interviewed about the device. However, the ninja managed to steal it back as Pythor chased them. Once backstage, Pythor threatened to throw sandbags at Zane while he was pinned down, so Lloyd decided to hand over the device. However, Pythor realized too late that it was a fake, being humiliated on live TV. An angry Pythor then left the studio and went into hiding once again. Pythor was busted by the new ninja team and taken to Cryptarium Prison. During this time, he learned that the Crystal King was recruiting the ninja's greatest enemies for his council. Believing he was going to be chosen, Pythor patiently waited for his invitation. Learning that the ninja were in Cryptarium Prison, Pythor went to the yard to greet his old chums. He noted how ironic it was that the ninja were locked in with all the villains they defeated until Kai reminded the Anakontrai that he was stuck in the prison too. Pythor used this to provoke the ninja, explaining how the new ninja were so much better than the old ones. He then told the heroes about someone gathering villains for their new army. Although Kai told him that wouldn't happen, Pythor merely laughed at them. An angry Kai then threw his tray at the Anakontrai, with the latter throwing some trays back. Some guards then broke up the battle and took Pythor to his cell. As he left, he shouted,
"For hail the Crystal King!"
During the night, some crystal spiders broke into Pythor's cell to wake him up. A hologram then projected an unknown person wearing a kabuki mask, with the stranger offering Pythor the opportunity to join the Council of the Crystal King. The Anakontrai gleefully accepted and escaped through a tunnel. By the time the ninja arrived at his cell, Pythor was already outside being carried by the crystal spiders. At the end of the balcony bridge, a crystal hovercraft came to pick him up. Pythor boarded the hovercraft, noting the first-class accommodations, and flew off as he laughed at the ninja. Pythor soon arrived at the crystal temple, where he waited for the villain's meeting to begin. Pythor was present at the meeting table when Lloyd, disguised as the mechanic, entered the room. There, Pythor introduced Mr. F as the upgraded model to Mr. E. When Esfera began longing for revenge against the ninja, Pythor mocked her desperation for vengeance. The mechanic then asked who was sitting in the last chair, to which Pythor replied that it was for the Crystal King. The kabuki-masked stranger suddenly appeared and told everyone that there was an imposter among them. The villains were shocked to learn this revelation and tried finding out who it was until the kabuki mask revealed it to be Lloyd disguised as the mechanic. As Lloyd tried to escape, Pythor shouted at the other villains to capture him. Lloyd then accidentally fired a flame at Pythor, but the Anakondri managed to dodge it. As Lloyd ran on, Pythor was able to catch him using his invisibility to sneak up on him. Although Lloyd broke free using Spinjitzu, Mr. F was able to stop him and the kabuki mask revealed himself to be Harumi. Pythor and the other members of the Crystal Council invaded the Monastery of Spinjitzu to search for the golden weapons. While facing Wu, Nia, Skylar, and Pixel, Esfera shouted for vengeance, to which Pythor shook his head in annoyance. The Crystal Council then engaged in battle with the defenders of the monastery. Pythor turned invisible before using his tail to throw Skylar away. He then went after Nia, using his invisibility to try and bite the water ninja. Pythor managed to strike Nia with his tail, telling her that he knew her powers were gone and that she should have stayed in the ocean. After these words, Pythor attempted to slash Nia with his Naginata, but Skylar took him down. Pythor then turned invisible, took back his Naginata, and attempted to slay Skylar with it, but was stopped by Nia. Pythor managed to wrap his tail around Nia and place his Naginata against her neck. However, Pixel released the mini-picks, freeing Nia from the Anakondri's grip. However, the arrival of the Crystal Spiders allowed the council members to defeat the defenders. The villains then took the golden weapons from their compartment, with Pythor taking the nunchucks of lightning. Noticing that the nunchucks were not connected by a chain, Pythor complained that they were useless. The council then left the monastery, leaving behind dozens of Crystal Spiders ready to explode. Pythor and the other council members returned to the Crystal Temple to find Lloyd in chains. They then stood in a circle around the central crystal. Pythor, like the others, placed his golden weapon on the crystal pedestal. Esfera then began reciting an incantation to start the ritual, with Pythor mimicking in annoyance. The golden weapons then transformed into the weapons of destruction. Once the ritual was completed, Pythor watched with shock as the Crystal King took physical form. With the Overlord back in Ninjago, the Dark Lord used his powers to crystallize the Crystal Council. The Nunchucks of Destruction then flew into Pythor's hands, with the Anakondri happy that his weapon worked. He then thanked his master and bowed to him, which the other council members did the same. The Overlord then lifted the Crystal Temple into the sky, impressing Pythor. When Lloyd managed to break free and tilt the floating island to the side, all the villains grabbed onto the crystals to avoid falling. The Overlord then re-stabilized this island and ordered his council members to destroy Lloyd. Pythor and the other villains immediately ran after him. Pythor turned invisible and blocked Lloyd's path, delighted in the fact that he got to face the Green Ninja alone. However, the other council members appeared, much to his disappointment. The villains then threw the golden weapons at Lloyd, causing them to collide. This created a wave of energy that knocked the council to the ground and allowed Lloyd to escape. Once Harumi joined them, Pythor asked where Lloyd went, to which Harumi lied and told them that he went down another corridor. The villains eventually found the right way and watched as Lloyd and Harumi fell off the island. Pythor and the other council members used their dragonides to fly after Lloyd and Harumi. When the Destiny's Bounty showed up, Pythor went to destroy the ship. However, Zane arrived and chased Pythor's dragonide through a canyon until Pythor crashed into a stone bridge. After Ninjago City was crystallized, Pythor was put in charge of some crystal warriors and tasked with finding the ninja. As Pythor searched the city, he was delighted to find Kai and Cole's crashed vehicles and used his tongue to pick up their scent. Sensing that they were close, Pythor slithered down an alley and sang for them to come out. Finally spotting them behind a container, Kai revealed himself and shot flames at the Anakondri. Pythor laughed at the fire ninja and told him that they didn't stand a chance. That is, until Skylar appeared. Recognizing her as the one who could absorb elemental powers, Pythor recoiled in fear. Skylar blasted fire and earth at Pythor, but he was able to block the attack with the nunchucks. Pythor admitted that her powers were impressive, but they were nothing compared to the Vengestone soldiers. Skylar then raised a stone wall to protect against the warriors. Pythor yelled for them to take the wall down and told the ninja that they could never hide. However, since no one was answering him, Pythor realized that he was talking to himself the whole time. Pythor and the other council members were called back to the Crystal Island by an enraged overlord. The overlord was furious over the fact that the council failed to bring back the ninja. Pythor attempted to talk the situation down, but the overlord prepared to destroy them. Fortunately, Harumi arrived with Mr. F, who had found the ninja's location, much to the Crystal Council's relief. Pythor, along with the Crystal Army, was deployed to the Paperboy's warehouse to battle the ninja. After the ninja unlocked dragon form, an invisible Pythor snuck up to the roof where Esfira was fighting Kai. Pythor wrapped his tail around the fire ninja, but Jay arrived and took him down. Although he fought back, Jay sent a lightning shockwave at the Anacondri, knocking him unconscious and taking back his nunchucks. After the battle, Pythor was arrested and taken back to Cryptarium Prison, disappointing his ancestors once again. Hey, thank you guys for watching. I hope you all enjoyed today's video, and remember to never trust a snake. But really, make sure to leave down in the comments what character you would like to see me go over next time. And remember, never put off until tomorrow what can be done today. Have a good one.